So, I am really privileged to have all of you in this session, and the purpose of this session is to give you a concrete plan for the next 90 days. And for those people who are new for the mains preparation, give them a complete idea about how to prepare for the GS mains examination, right? So let me introduce myself. My name is CA Rahul Kumar. I am the one of the faculty and also one of the director at Didami.com, and I appeared 3 times in the IAS interview. I qualified prelims examination 5 times. So I have a very in-depth relationship with this examination and the entire process. So let us begin. So let me share with you, if you have any query, just type in the chat box and I will reply each and every query at the end of the session. Plus, I will give you a chance to speak out and ask any question at the end itself. Okay. So the duration of this session will be approximately 40 minutes to 50 minutes. After that, I will give you open chance to ask any question. I will be available here to give answer to each and every of your question. Right. So now let us start. This seminar or this webinar is part of the Margdarshan series which we are having at Didami. So already we have completed with economy, we have completed current affairs strategy, we are discussing GS mains strategy on 9th of October. So this date is changed. On 9th of October, that is day after tomorrow, at same time we will discuss about answer writing, how to write the best answer for the GS mains. On 12th of October, one of our faculty will discuss about how to write the essay in the best possible manner. On 15th of October, we will have the session about international relations that will be taken by another faculty. Then on 19th and 25th, we will have some sessions for the prelims examination. So this series is going on, and the past sessions, PowerPoint presentation as well as the YouTube sessions are already there on the website. Now let me share with you the coverage of this session. So I will discuss how to utilize next 3 months, what should be done for the answer writing. So detailed on the answer writing we will be doing in the next session. Daily timetable, what should be the daily timetable. Systematic preparation of the GS mains, what it takes to score 450 marks, right? Value addition tools, what all is required, case study, facts and so many other things. How to prepare the mains current affair. Then there are certain pitfalls where many people struggle. So I will discuss about that also. So to start with, the first question and the biggest question is for those people who have just appeared for the prelims 2020, which happened on 4th of October, right? So I have been receiving calls, messages, emails, and you have been sharing about your examination. And there are people who are in 3 categories, right? So if I say these are the 3 categories, first, those people who are getting more than 100 marks. So you are 100% clear. Assume that you are 100% clear. You have to just focus on the examination preparation of the GS mains and the optional. If you are hovering between 90 to 100, this is the most doubtful category. But let me tell you, these people should be focusing on 100% mains preparation, because this year examination has been little bit on the difficulty side. So 90 marks can be the cutoff. I am not saying, as per me, the cutoff should be around 95 to plus minus 2. But if you are scoring 90 or above and you are in the general category, then you must focus on the mains examination. Don't focus on the anything else. If you are getting below 90 marks, so this is 90 marks. If you are getting below 90 marks, even then you have to focus on the mains examination. Why I am saying this? I am saying this because Next year, prelims is happening on 27th of June. And the mains is happening on, is starting from 17th September 2021. So you have approximately 80 days. In these 80 days, it is not possible to prepare for the mains examination in a systematic manner. You can just revise, write answer, and manage the current affair. So the best time is next 4 months. That is from October to January. So if you are appearing, if you get a admit card for the mains examination, then you will write your examination in the UPSC exam hall. If you do not get your admit card, that means you do not qualify your prelims examination, then you will be writing the same examination at your home. So the point is, stop thinking what is the result. That time is gone. You are a fighter. You have to just focus on the fight. So whether you are writing in the exam hall or you are writing at your home, you have to write the mains 2020 paper. That should be your goal, because the same people who are appearing in the mains 2020 this year, they will be competing with you next year. So you have to be ready to compete with them next year. Are you getting? So it does not matter what is your score for the prelims. What matters is that you are focusing 100% energy in the mains examination. For the prelims examination, what you can, those people, I'm telling about those people who are very clear that they are not getting clear in the prelims examination. For those people, you can focus 20% of your time for the prelims examination, and in this 20% time, you should focus on the current affair plus join some test series, right? Start from the basics. So this should be your strategy. Now, those people who are appearing for the first time in 2021, so either you have just started, means you just started the UPSC preparation during last 2-3 months, then first complete the basic books and read the newspaper. Your mains preparation should start once you are completed with the basic books at least once. Then there is second category of people who are already comfortable with the prelims examination. They have prepared enough in the past also. They did not appear this year because of some other reason. So they people should completely focus on the mains examination, right? So they should also write the mains 2020 paper at their home on the same day when the examination will be conducted by the UPSC, right? So this is your overall approach. Now coming to the systematic approach. So you will divide the total time period between the prelims 2020 and the mains 2020 in 3 period, okay? So this 3 period will be in the form of between now till 15th of November. So why 15th of November? This is the expected date of results of UPSC prelims examination. Between now and the 15th November, your 40% syllabus of the GS mains must be completed, and in the optional you must complete one full paper. This should be your target at any cost. So between now and 15th November, there are approximately 40 days. In 40 days, you have to complete 40% syllabus. Now, what should be the key area in this 40%? So only that area which you did not cover early. And that is also important. This should be your first priority. If you did not cover ethics, cover ethics. If you did not cover world history, cover world history. Just give 2 days to the world history, not more than that. So depending upon the importance of the paper, you have to cover those area and feel confident, and simultaneously you have to prepare other areas. Then in the optional, either you can pick up one paper, complete that, you join some test series, some class, whatsoever you want to do, complete one paper 100%. Or what you can do, you can prepare 50% of paper 1 and 50% of paper 2. This is must for everyone. If you are clearing the, it does not matter if you are clearing the prelims 2020 or not, does not matter. You have to have this target at any cost, right? Then from 16th November to 20th December, again we are having around 35 days. In this 35 days, those people, especially those people who are clearing the prelims examination, they will be focusing on rest of the 60% syllabus of the GS paper and the second paper of the optional. Now you will say, sir, in 40 days you are saying 40% syllabus, in 35 days you are saying 60% syllabus. Why I am saying is they, because in the starting your speed will be little bit less, but after the result comes, after the prelims result comes, you will automatically be running, right? So now coming to the third period, which starts from 21st December to 7th of January. This is the exam date. So in this time, you will be just revising, nothing else. So divide this total time period into three categories. Now, what about answer writing? First of all, in the answer writing also, you have to divide period into three categories. And you have to divide your answer writing into three categories: GS, optional, and essay. In the GS paper, you should practice minimum 2 questions and up to 4 questions on a daily basis. Plus, you should attempt 10 questions on the every Saturday or Sunday. Right? Why I am saying, if you write answer on a daily basis, you can improve your skill. You can see how to write introduction, conclusion, and so on. And if you attempt 10 questions on every Saturday, that will be having a complete feeling of the total test, the full test, where you will be focusing on the speed, how to manage the 10 questions simultaneously, like that. So it should be a combination. It should not be just answer writing daily basis or attempting full test. It should be a combination. In optional, you should attempt minimum 2 questions and up to 4 questions. If you are already comfortable, if you have already appeared for the mains, then you can attempt more questions also. So it depends upon your preparation. In case of essay, you should write 1 essay on every Sunday, right? With full systematic format. And so 1 essay you will be writing fully, and for 1 essay you will be preparing the format or structure. Don't write it fully, right? So this is how you should approach for the essay paper. From 16th November to 20th December, you must write 4 questions daily at any cost, because writing will really improve your performance drastically. Plus, you must attempt full test on every weekend so that you can gear up yourself for the complete paper in the UPSC exam hall. Similarly, for the optional also, 4 questions daily plus full test. And in case of essay, every Sunday you will be attempting 2 full tests. Sorry, 2 full essay paper, that is 1 complete test. Then after 21st of December, you will be focusing on full test in a systematic manner, in the same manner in which UPSC is conducting the examination, GS1, GS2, GS3, GS4, essay, and then optional 1 and 2, right? So in a simulated environment, prepare the entire structure. And your compulsory papers, for the compulsory papers, the language papers, there is no need of worry. For these compulsory papers, what you can do, just find 30 minutes in your spare time and go through the previous year question bank with a solution. So find in the market the previous year question bank with the solution and just keep flipping, keep identifying the difficult area, keep underlining that. 30 minute daily basis, complete that, so that you do not become part of those 5% unlucky people whose result is not declared because of the compulsory paper not getting clear, right? Now, next is answer writing. So I already gave you a brief, but detailed analysis we will do on 9th October, 8 PM. We will discuss all the possible ideas, how to write introduction, how to write conclusion, how to get high marks, how to manage the time, how to manage the word limit, how we can learn from the topper's copies, and all the possible dimensions, everything I will discuss on 9th of October, 8 PM. Now, what should be the daily timetable? Sir, you have already told me I have to cover 40% syllabus of GS mains, 1 complete paper of optional, and then I have to write essay, 4 questions daily. So, sir, kaise hoga ye? And then I have to cover the current affair also. So for that there is a simple plan which you must follow. So number one, on a daily basis you have to have the revision, because this is the most ignored area. If you don't do the revision, whatever you are reading, that will be useless, right? Number two, you have to give 5 hours for the optional at any cost. Optional cannot be ignored. Optional can take you from a low rank to a very high rank. So don't ignore this. 30 minutes for the optional answer writing. If you are more comfortable, you can get more time out of the 5 hours for the answer writing. You can write 4 answer also. Then 1 hour should be given for the daily current affair, right? 1 hour means 1 hour. That means on a daily basis, you open the newspaper and I will tell you how to cover. 1 hour you must give for the answer writing. So in the starting, don't try to stick to the time limit. Focus on the quality and take your time and write the best possible answer on a daily basis. Then you have 5 hours and 30 minutes. During this time, you should pick up any 2 paper out of GS 1, 2, 3, 4. Rather, you should focus more upon 2, 3, 4, because in the GS 1, you have already completed history, the basics of geography, then art and culture, all of that in the prelims examination. There are some current affairs, those can be covered here. So this is how you should approach your day. So how many hours? 6.5, 7.5, 8.5, 9. So 14 hours. You must have this kind of schedule without any break, right? There is no compromise possible in this break. You can see we have very limited time. Now how to utilize 1 hour of the current affair? Take a watch, right? Almost have a, every moment you must have a watch with yourself. I don't have it right now, but I usually have it. Buy a watch. If you don't have a watch, don't rely on the mobile. Mobile is a very time wasting thing many a time, right? So buy a watch and set a time limit of 5 minutes and just flip through the page, read the headline, identify the topic which you have to cover in the next 55 minutes. Then take 40 minutes. In this 40 minutes, you should cover at least 2 to 3 editorials and just write down the keywords in a side. Don't give much time, because this is not the syllabus. You are just reading this for your updation, for your continuity. Then last 15 minutes, you should look for the important facts, the important role models, case studies, and just write it down in a separate page. So this is your structure for the 1 hour current affair. Do not ignore daily newspaper. There is no replacement of daily newspaper. You can read any compilation, any monthly magazine, but if you are serious for the mains examination, don't ignore this. I never recommend to ignore the newspaper. So this is the daily news prescription which we are providing at our Telegram channel. You can join the Telegram channel and this list you can find. In just 5 minutes, look out for these news. Read the first paragraph if possible. If you have time, first paragraph in the 10 minutes and just think where you can apply that. Now coming to the next thing, that is fragmented GS mains strategy. So nowadays you will be getting lot of material, and the biggest problem is the aspirants are always in doubt how to prepare for the GS mains. So what they do, they take static notes from one place or one institute, they take current affair of second institute, then they join answer writing or test series at third institute, and then they pick up the revision notes or the current compilation before the examination from the fourth institute. So what are they doing? They are just complicating their preparation. How is that? Because if suppose you say take one subject, one topic, green economy. So if you are taking the static notes of one institute, they will pick up one definition of green economy. Then this current affair note, they will pick up another definition. Then if you are lucky, in the answer writing you can get any definition out of this in the model answer, or they can pick up third definition also. And in the compilation, if you are lucky, they can pick up definition from any of these, otherwise they will pick up a new definition. So your mind will not be able to retain any of the definition. At the end, you will end up writing your own definition of green economy. Are you getting? So this is how the preparation becomes complex, fragmented, and you are left confused at the end of the day, and you think, I will prepare my best next year, and that next year does not come anytime. Next year kabhi nahi aata hai, theek hai? Every year it is the same, because you have shortage of time and you have so many sources to read. Now sir, you will say, how to then, what should be the approach? Sir, approach kya hona chahiye fir? So you must follow a simple strategy, and then there are very well defined sources you must follow, and you already know about it. So start from the previous year question. They are the best friend. Do the complete analysis of every paper topic wise. Pick up paper 1, pick up social issues, and see what are the questions that came in the women's organization, right? And second, pick up the UPSC syllabus. This is the second best friend. In the UPSC syllabus, they are giving the systematic subtopics of every topic. For example, about food processing, they are giving upstream, downstream requirement, challenges, etc. So this is the second source that you must have. So prepare the list of topics from here. Prepare the second list from here. Integrate them in a Word file or Excel file as per your choice. Then you must identify the static issues or topic list based upon these two sources only, right? Then you must pick up last 2 years current affair and find out the list of issues which have been in news in the last 2 years. And I will tell you at the end of this session how to do that, okay? How to identify the list of issues. So one thing you must understand is that in the GS mains examination, they will not ask about any event. They will not ask about any concept. They will ask about the issue. For example, if there is a gang rape in the Hathras, they will ask about crimes against women, the woman empowerment, the social mindset about women, like that. So you have to identify the issues. And there are many people who are asking me, sir, how much should be the period of current affairs? My friend, if you pick up the 1000 issues out of the GS 1, 2, 3, 4, then there is no need of defining what should be the period. I will tell you more about that in the current affair part of this session. So list of the last 2 years current affair you must find out. And finally, prepare the list from all these sources. Means you are integrating all these sources in a single Word file or Excel file, right? Don't use hard copy, because then you will not be able to, you know, exchange the topic, like you cannot arrange the topic systematically. And in the last, prepare every topic in the 360 degree manner. So there will be at most 1000 issues if we cover all these points. 1000 issues you must cover in a systematic manner, okay? Now you can see this is the previous year compilation. So you must have this kind of compilation. This is already available on our website. You can find from there. I will tell you how to get that. So in the GS3 Indian Economy Planning Resources Growth in 2019, there were two questions. 2018, then there were two questions, then three questions, then 2017, like that. So you must find out this list. Then you must prepare this kind of list of the total topics. So this is about the GS3. In the first topic is Indian economy during British's time and at the time of independence. So economic planning, liberalization, privatization, globalization, Niti Aayog versus Planning Commission, India versus China, green economy, direct shift from the agriculture to industry, then inclusive growth, then poverty, unemployment, demographic dividend, inequality. So you will group all the same similar topic together, and this list is already available on our website. I will tell you how to get it, okay? So if you want to save your time, you can get from the website. I will tell you how to do that. Now there are 1000 topic. Every topic is not equally important, and every topic does not have the equal content on the from the different sources. So what you should do, you should make the ABC list. What is ABC list? The priority list. A is the top priority list. In the top priority, you will be having 50% topic. These are the best possible topic based upon the previous question and the syllabus. And you must prepare this topic in a very, very, very integrated and systematic manner, no compromise. The second is medium priority, 25% topic. And third is the low priority, that is the 25% topic. So prepare in this manner only. So out of the 1000 issues, identify which are the top 50% issues and start preparing 360 degree for every topic. Now I will tell you how to prepare in the 360 degree manner. What should be the approach for every topic, right? So let me sum up. So far what we have done, we have prepared the list of topic. Second, what we have done, we have divided the topic into high priority, medium priority and low priority. And now we are discussing how to approach for every topic. So for every topic, first of all, if you are preparing for a sufficient time, if you are reading the newspaper, then you must be having something in your mind about every topic. So if I ask you what are the reasons of poverty, you can write 3-4 points. If I ask you why India's parliament is not performing well, you can write 3-4 points. If I ask you why Gandhiji's ideals are important today's world, you can write 3-4 points. So just brainstorm whatever you know, so that when you brainstorm, you will start feeling vacuum that you don't know many dimensions. You may be good at few dimensions, but maybe not very good in other dimension. So start finding out those dimensions and then start doing research on those dimension. This research will be based upon the static plus current both, and I will tell you how to do that, what should be the approach for the research. Third is compile. Okay, so before compilation, you must know the difference between the dimension versus point. I will tell you with an example after some time. So when you are doing the research, don't research the point, or don't focus on the point, rather focus on the dimension, and inside every dimension give the point as an example. Then consolidate. The consolidation of all this research is very, very important. If it is not consolidated, then it is useless. Okay, you cannot recall in the exam hall. Now what should be the 360 degree approach for every topic? So this thing you already know, I just want to re-emphasize again so that you become more convinced about your strategy. You must have the basic meaning and definition from the authentic sources. You must have the historical evolution, what is the need of anything. For example, what is the need of disinvestment, the description of the basic details about that particular concept or any particular concept, then key facts and figures about the topic, benefits, disadvantages, then the government initiatives, it includes budget initiatives and other initiatives, challenges and issues in the implementation of these initiatives and otherwise also, the recommendations of Niti Aayog, economic survey, role model or best practices and the case studies, the way forward and the suggestion. And after you are done with this research, then start finding out what are the possible maze questions from that particular topic and prepare the structure of the answer, that how much you will, what will be your introduction, what will be your body, what will be your conclusion, and how much strength you will give to each of these part. This structure is must so that you are exam ready, because ultimate purpose is to perform in the exam hall. The purpose is not to just compile the list and become the doctor. Okay, now what should be the source for core syllabus? Static portion. So core syllabus, you already know there are various sources, and there are some very good sources which I want to tell you. You will not find about them anywhere else. So there is a very good book. This book is called Concise Oxford Companion to the Economics. This book has given very, very beautiful dimensions on multiple topics, which includes agriculture, contract farming. So contract farming is in news because of this farmer issues, right? Then land reforms, rural credit, industrial policy, banking, financial sector, financial inclusion, infrastructure reforms, demographic dividend. All of these topics are very, very important. And this is written by Kaushik Basu, who is a very prominent economist. So many dimensions you can take from here in the GS3 and GS2 topic, and including the GS1 topic, for example, demographic dividend. Then there is a very good book, India Since Independence. All of you must be reading this, but you must utilize this book in a systematic manner. For example, for the land reforms, for the Nexalism, then for this terrorism, then for women's empowerment, women's organizations, tribals, regionalism, secularism. This has very good content, and you must have the good content from this book. Then third book is Uma Kapila. This book is also very prominent book, the performance and policies. This also talks about various dimensions in a systematic manner. Then for the governance, we have many book, for example, Lakshmikant, Second ARC, PRS is a very good website which gives you details about how to analyze the recent development. Then Supreme Court judgment. These are the core things, and then there are many other sources. I'm not going into detail. For GS2, GS3, we will be having a separate session where I will tell you how to prepare the GS2, how to prepare the GS3 in a systematic manner. Now, this is one of the sample how we prepare on a single topic, right? For example, this is the topic of disinvestment. You must prepare what was the status before at the time of independence, why rationals were dominating at the time of independence, the problem faced by PSUs in 1991, meaning of the disinvestment, purpose, policy of the government, what were the major developments which were brought by the new government in 1617, then department, then argument for disinvestment, against disinvestment. This is very, very crucial because mains examination will come properly from this area. So this analytical portion should be focused more 1, 2, 3 and 9, 10. And rest of the things are just for the sake of completion. And then role of PSU today, way forward and conclusion. So this is how you must prepare the. This is how you should prepare for the every topic. And first, make the list of dimension which you need to prepare for every topic. And then start doing the research. Okay. And in between the research, if you find something, then include that also as the subtopic. And for example, you can see this historical evolution about the financial inclusion. So if there is a question about financial inclusion, there is an essay about this, we can say the financial inclusion initiatives belong to very, very old time, from 1806-1904. You don't need to remember all these points. The point is you can go back to the earliest time, and in the introduction, in the transition line, you can use these points, right? No need to basically remember each of them. For example, this is about parliament. So in the parliament, you can compare the situation between 1947 to 1967, 1967 to 1990, 1991 to 2014 and 2014 to now. So these are the four period. If you divide the parliament working in four period, you can give various dimension in case of policy reforms, in case of role of governor, in case of center state relations. So this is called historical dimension, right? Now this is another example of local self-government. So starting from Vedic time, Gupta time, Britishers time, then why Britishers focused on the local self-government, then after independence there have been various committees. So you don't need to get into much detail. You just prepare these synoptic notes, and the purpose is just to give the reference at whichever place it is required, not to basically write the complete 250 words on this point, right? Then similarly, I have already told you about disinvestment on the time of independence. This was the point. Then second point is authentic definition. This is very, very important. For example, if you talk about the informal sector and employment, so there are various definitions, there are various concepts which many people are not clear. For example, this National Commission for Enterprises in Unorganized Sector, it has given the classification and it has talked about unorganized sector, informal worker separately. And what is the meaning of formal worker? So there is a lot of confusion about these basic terms. You must know these terms very, very systematically and very, very clearly, so that if the exam, in the exam hall, you can write in two lines and also can give the reference from the authentic source, right? Then for example, in the same topic, you can give the exam reference of economic survey. For example, as per the economic survey of 1718, the informality can be judged on three magnitudes, right? So basically the point I want to make is you must have the authentic sources for the definition, and you must write the name of the source and find the dimension accordingly and use that at the time of examination. For example, this is the about e-commerce. So the latest draft national e-commerce policy has given the systematic definition of e-commerce. So you must compile these definition and write at a single place, or maybe in your research. Then I told you very basic point, dimension versus point, right? So when you are reading for a long time, what people do, they start compiling the point. For example, there is a very simple example, government policies on the unemployment generation. If I ask you, you can tell me 50 point on this topic, but how to present in the exam hall? So in the exam hall, we will classify these employment policies into various dimension. For example, promotion of labor intensive industry sector. Inside this, we can talk about construction sector focus through PM Awas Yojana, RERA, black money focus, and there are other point. Focus on tourism, focus on textile sector. So these are the like around 10 point, and we have categorized these 10 point into single category. Similarly, entrepreneurship mindset, labor reforms, focus on data generation, MSME focus, and we can give every inside every point, we can give multiple point, right? So you have to focus on the dimension, don't focus on the point. Point should be given only as a example, right? So in the exam, you should at the time of research, you should focus on the dimension. For example, this is about e-governance. So in case of e-governance, what are the issues? You should divide into the demand side and supply side. In the supply side, you should focus on what are the infrastructure issues and what are the other issues. If you think in this manner, then you will be able to comprehend the entire matter in a minimum possible time. Then there is issues about RTA working. This is another topic. So what are the systematic issues? What are the ground issues? And what are the other issues, right? The information commissioner related issues. So if you categorize your point into these three categories, then you will be able to remember all of them, and you will be able to get high marks in the exam hall also, because your answer writing will be better. Similarly, what are the issues in the drought management, the lacuna of planning, the faulty agricultural and water management practices, and lacunas in management. So if you divide your point into these three subcategories and write 3-4 points about each of them, then you can definitely have a systematic notes and you can revise later, right? So this is what I want to say. Focus on the dimension, and inside the dimension, write the point. Now you will say, sir, in the exam hall, they will not ask these issues in 250 word. So why are you writing so many point? My friend, these number of point you might not be having, but I am having these. I have done proper research. And in your case, if you just write 2-3 point on every dimension, that is more than sufficient. But try to have these point from authentic sources and in a very crisp manner. Now, how to do the value addition? This is another dimension, right? So far we have discussed about how to prepare in the 360 degree manner. Once you have done that, how to do the value addition in that. So for the value addition, you must give the reference of the government document or the report. For example, if you are taking the data of demographic dividend from the economic survey, write that as per the economic survey 1920, this is the data or this is the observation, because that will give the credibility. You must refer to the Niti Aayog recommendation. Niti Aayog has 7-year agenda, 3-year document. So you should focus upon that also, right? Economic survey, I already told you. Then there are various quotations which can be used. For example, there are quotations about reservation, about the work, the role of parliament, about the role of governor, various constitutional makers, Ambedkar Saab, etc. They have given various quotations, various important statements on various issues. So you can have those at include those at the relevant places. Then make a list of key terminologies of every subject. Every subject has some key terminology. For example, in GS2, there are good governance, parliament, the various committees, then keywords, they include like cooperative federalism, right? So these kind of keywords you should write down separately, and you must use them again and again so that this answer can look as of GS2. Similarly, in the GS3, there are various good terms. For example, sustainable development, and there are various other terms which I will tell you later. And you should make the list at a separate page so that you can get the good marks in the exam. Then you can have the good statement and lines from the president and prime minister speech, because they are doing very good researched speaking, right? Then second ARC you already know, and I will tell you one very good source, that is Yojana chief editor's desk page. That is a kind of editorial page which is the like starting page of the Yojana itself. I will tell you how to utilize that. So starting from this only, Yojana chief editor desk page, so this is one of the example. This page, which comes in the as the first page of every Yojana magazine, monthly magazine, you must read that, and you must see how they have included multiple dimension at the single place, how they have integrated the data, how they have integrated the various statement historical dimension, recent development, everything, right? And you can get lot of idea about how to write the answer, how to write the essay, how to write the introduction, how to minimize the number of word while including all the possible point. So you must follow last 2 years chief editor desk document, and we have made available this document on our website in the free download section. So you can go there and download from there, and you can enjoy reading these documents from last 2 years. Then second thing is key facts, how to integrate key fact. For example, this is the key fact about privatization of banks in India. So if you are doing the debate about privatization of bank, then you must give the reference from some very authentic source. For example, the recent economic survey talks about the inefficiencies of the public sector bank. So if you give this kind of data, then your argument in favoring the privatization becomes more authentic. So even if you utilize one line, that is more than sufficient, but you must do that. Then second example is key facts, for example about renewable energy. This key facts are basically from the ministry website. If you go to the Ministry of Renewable Energy, you will find this in the first page itself. So this is giving very authentic recent data. If you take one statement, for example, the India is now at fifth position in the renewable energy, and you utilize that in your introduction body conclusion, then you will be getting extra marks. Similarly, you can take the initiatives from the recent budget. For example, in the financial inclusion, the recent budget has given these latest initiatives. Then there is economic survey. In this economic survey, there is a very good list of 10 ideas, good ideas, and you can utilize these ideas at different places. So if you are writing the answer of MSME, if you are writing the answer of sustainable development, you can pick maybe 2-3 points from this and give the reference that as per the economic survey, these ideas can be implemented, and you can utilize them in the conclusion, etc. Then you must also find good points from the Niti Aayog, as I told you, and give the reference as per the Niti Aayog, this is this. Just write 2-3 points and you will be getting extra attention from the examiner, right? And similarly, this is one of the way forward which we have taken from economic survey 1819, and this talks about the MSME and the labor reforms. So if you are writing these two answers, then you can utilize the economic survey data. So basically all these sources which I am telling you, economic survey, Niti Aayog, don't read them in silo, don't read them individually, rather try to integrate them right at a single place. Then this, try to make this kind of flow chart. For example, this flow chart is about improvement in the quality of public service delivery and the integrated approach. So this overall flow chart talks about the Sivottam model. If you make this flow chart in the exam, then examiner will give you 1 or 2 extra marks because you have given all the possible dimensions of the Sivottam model, right? So these diagrams should not be taken very casually, and they should not be taken from here and there, rather they should be from the authentic sources. For example, this diagram I have taken from the one of the government document about this Citizen Charter and the Sivottam model. Similarly, second ARC has very good recommendation about various topic, especially for the GS paper 2 and for the disaster management in the GS paper 3. So what you should do, you should make a summary of those point, because entire report is not relevant. In the exam hall, you will just be quoting 1 or 2 point here and there. So just try to write the keyword in a simple manner in your notes. Then Supreme Court judgment, you must make a list of Supreme Court judgment at the end of every topic. For example, this is about the governor's role, right? And there are very important judgments, right? And try to have underlining of the keyword so that at the time of revision you can revise them very very easily. Then there are various good case studies, you must also find them and make a try to integrate at the in the given notes only. So first of all, I want to tell you one thing, that you must have the single notebook, and for every topic you must have dedicated number of pages, and you must basically try to include everything relating to that topic in the given page only. For example, if I make the notes of financial inclusion, then I have to write out everything about financial inclusion, the historical dimension, the key facts, the recent developments, challenges, the government initiatives, the way forward, Niti Aayog recommendation, economic survey observation, the case studies. So everything should be at single place so that in the exam hall you are able to revise. Otherwise, it is humanly not possible to revise each and everything. So this is one example of the case study. For example, the contract farming potato by Food and Agricultural Organization, where FAO has recommended about the contract farming. So this is in the context of recent farm bill, which is in controversy. So this kind of case study you can use for justifying the point. Similarly, this is another case study about technology role in the farming, and this is from the Bihar. So you can quote this in the conclusion also. Similarly, this is another case study. This is of the global level, the clean coal, USA and the China, how they have done very well in the clean coal. So if there is a question on the renewable energy, you can utilize that. Then there is a crowdfunding example. The IAS officer Armstrong team, he has done very good job. So basically you should try to find out different kind of case study. Then this is about FDI FPI in the India solar sector. Then there are very good president and prime minister speeches. Try to pick very good words from there. For example, Vasudev Kutumbakam, and see how they are utilizing human centric collaboration, economic centric inclusion, right? So you must include all these points in your answers, essays, and then that will give you another edge, and you will come to know how the speeches of big executives are written. Similarly, this is the Prime Minister speech about Namami Ganga, and he has given various dimensions and strategy. So you will find the point as well as the good language from these speeches, right? But don't overdo, just focus on the key speeches, the president, the post Independence Day speech and the Republic Day speech, like that. Don't overdo this, okay? Then success stories, for example, green economy, we have your example of Korea, Mexico. Then we have various other countries examples, right? So this kind of role models you can give in certain areas. It is not possible to have this in every topic, but as much as possible, try to do that. Okay, yeah. So how to prepare the current affairs? First of all, this is the list of sources. You must be knowing this. Yojana, Kurukshetra, Economic Survey, PIB, Niti Aayog, everyone knows about it. No need to tell more about it. But how to prepare the current affairs? That is a problem for the mains examination. So for the mains examination, we have to identify the list of issues, which I already told you. So pick up the current monthly current affair compilation and try to list down the issues into GS1, 2, 3 and 4. Similarly, the last 18 month Hindu editorials and the op-ed page, the important issues you must find from there. Indian Express and editorials and explained page, last 18 month important points you should write at a single place. Similarly, Yojana magazine, last 18 month the list of important issues. Kurukshetra magazine, Rajya Sabha TV. So basically what I am trying to say is, I am not saying that you must read the entire Yojana magazine, Kurukshetra magazine, Rajya Sabha TV debate. No, that is not what I am saying. What I am saying is, just list down the list of issues which are appearing, which are being discussed in the Rajya Sabha and so on, and then try and verify whether that topic is there in the 1000 topic list or not. If it is not there, then add that topic and research on that topic, prepare that topic in a comprehensive manner, right? So Rajya Sabha TV, Kurukshetra, all these you can basically refer for the making list of topic, and if you find some good point, you can take from here. Otherwise, do the complete research. AIR Daily News and Economic Survey Volume 1 of last 2 years. So basically these sources you must prepare and try to compare with your existing list. And let me tell you, I have already done the research on this topic till the month of September, and I will be sharing that with you. And the final research, the final list of compilation, which are covering every possible source, I have done that also, right? So you can utilize that, and I will try to upload in the website free of cost for all of you. Okay, now the most important, right? So far we have covered number one, how to start making the list of topic from the previous year question, from the syllabus, and then recently I covered about the current affairs. Secondly, then I talked about how to prepare for every topic. So cover 360 degree approach and then value addition tools, right? Now I am going to cover how to do the effective revision, because everything you are reading today if you don't carry to the exam hall, it is useless. Okay, why? Because in the exam hall, if you are not able to recall, then it does not matter, because examiner don't know whether you have read the topic or not. Examiner will come to know only if you write in the answer sheet. So how to do the effective revision? Effective revision involves three strategy: daily revision, weekly revision, exam time revision. And friends, whether you are preparing for prelims or mains, whether you are preparing for 2020 or 2021, it does not matter. So you have to have this strategy only, because our mind has a tendency to forget the things. You must have a scientific technology through which you will be able to retain the maximum possible matter. Otherwise, you will end up reading so many things and not digesting, and that will be useless. So for daily revision, you should have the first hour of the day or last 1 hour of the day. And in this 1 hour, you should complete the previous day topics. So when you are reading the topic, making the notes, underlining the keywords, next day you will revise the same point and your retention will increase by 20%. On a weekly basis, you will be having 1 day. I have told Sunday, it can be any other day also. So 1 day in a week, you must have only for the revision. In this day, you will not be doing anything else, only and only revision for the coverage of last 6 days. Whatever you have read in the last six days, you will just be revising, not doing nothing else. Then what will be the source? The source will be last 6 days topic or your reading material. Third is exam time revision. This is very, very crucial. So what happens? For example, I have told you that on 21st of December, you must start the revision for the next 2 weeks before the mains 2020 examination. Many people, they will stretch this to the 31st December. So they will have only 1 week for the revision, exam time revision. And it will not be humanly possible to revise the notes or your anything if you don't have the systematic mind maps and exam time tools. So for that, what you will be doing is basically, you will be first of all allocating 2 complete days for every subject in advance. GS2, 2 days, GS1, 2 days, GS3, 2 days, like that. And on these 2 days, you will be revising only from your mind map, exam time synoptic notes, or revisionary clip, or a combination of all of them. In some topic, you have the mind map with your own hand. In some topic, you have the exam time synopsis of a single page. And in some cases, you have the revisionary clip of 5 minutes of every topic. So try to ensure that you have maximum 5 minutes for the revision of every topic. Because in that case, if you are reading for 14 hours, even then allocating 5 minutes means how many topic you can cover? 14 into 12. That comes to 168 topic in a day, right? And in every paper, you are having approximately 300 to 350 topic or 400 topic. So in 2 days, you can complete the revision only if you are allocating just 5 minutes. And the revision is possible in 5 minutes only and only from the handmade mind map, preferably with your own hand, or exam time synoptic notes and the revisionary clip. And I will tell you about these three tools now. So for these three tools, I will tell you basically one page mind map, exam time synopsis, and the revisionary audio and the video. So how to do that? For example, this is the topic of the corruption. So here you have told about the definition of Transparency International, given the key data as per the India Corruption Survey, the different causes which include social psycho causes, political causes, and written the keywords: excessive consumerism, nepotism, receding moral values. You have written all the possible causes. Then what is the impact? Inflation, diversion of fund from the productive to the luxury sector. Then you have talked about the measures, the legal measures, the agency measures. Then the reasons for failure, and you have just written the keyword, and the second AIC recommendation, Niti Aayog recommendation, and the suggestions: decentralization, RTI, state funding, social audit, tax reform. Oh, so what can you see? If you have this mind map in your hand at the time of examination, no force in the world can stop you to revise this topic in the 5 minutes. And in the exam, if there is a paper, if there is a question on the essay or question in the GS paper 2, you can just print this mind map right in the language form. no force in the world can stop you from getting the very high marks. Are you getting, my friends? So you have to do this work now, right? If you have not done, you have to do this now. I have given another example, Lokpal, and you can see, I will upload the PPT on the website and you can download from there. I will tell you from where to download, okay? And I will show you other very, very useful tools which you can utilize from the website. Similarly, this is a mind map on the pressure groups. Then, now coming to the exam time synopsis. For example, this is the exam time synopsis of food processing sector. So, the status of food processing sector, the need, the potential, the challenges, the government initiative, the way forward. And only the keyword. For example, we talk about challenges, poor supply chain linkage, lack of skilled manpower, low adherence to quality standard, variety of taxes, lack of R&D, sanitary cycle, phytosanitary regulations, cost effective technologies, food safety laws. So can you see, in just one paragraph, you have completed all the possible points. If you are able to recall only 5 points from these 10 points, no force in this world can stop you from getting good marks in that particular question. So if you have just one page note of a particular topic, then can you see that this is really possible to complete the revision at the time of examination. So this exam time synopsis is really wonderful work that you can do, right? So first is mind map, second is exam time synopsis. Now I have given other examples, you can see other examples as well for your own benefit. Then third is the revisionary clips. What you should do, you should take your mobile phone, and when on a daily basis you are revising the topic. For example, I said you have 1 hour of for the revision. Either it is in the morning or it is in the evening, or either it is in the first hour of the day or last hour of the day. So what you should do, you should download some audio recording software, or you can also do the video recording, and just explain every given topic in 5 minutes in your own voice. Try to have this in your own voice. For example, this complete topic of Kha Panchayat, surrogacy, for example, this topic of internal displacements of tribe. If you record in 5 minutes in this tool in the mobile phone, then the same recording you will save in the computer, and in the before the examination you will just listen to your own recording, and it is so useful, I can't tell you, right? So useful that in just 5 minutes you have covered every topic. Even if you are not feeling to read, even if you don't want to see the paper, you are just enjoying your food and revise, and your revision clip is telling you the point. Are you getting, my friends? These are some of the research which I have done in my own preparation. Okay, so this is the approach which you should follow. So are you getting three approaches so far? The mind map, exam time synopsis, and third is the revisionary clip. Are you getting? Is it possible to complete the revision in the 5 minutes? Say yes or no. Tell me, is it possible now? It is perfectly possible. And do this for your optional paper. Okay, if you don't do this for the GS paper, do this for optional paper. Optional paper, you must do that. In GS, I can provide you all of that. I will tell you more about it now. Revisionary clip, so you can see these are like various revisionary clip which I have with me. We are providing to the mains booster students. And now there is a very good another technology which you should use to remember maximum things, that is acronym. Okay, so for example, in case of regionalism, we can utilize this acronym in the conclusion. INCO, ideology, national building, cooperative federalism, not one size fits all approach. Communal violence, SRCS, societal imbalance, rumors, constitutionalism, sarvdharm, sambhav. Just compile them, and before the examination, out of the when you are outside your exam hall, have this list in your hand. When you enter in the exam hall, open the question paper. When you find the topic of communal violence or secularism, just write this immediately so that you don't forget when you're writing the answer. Okay, so this will give you edge because you will be able to carry this to the exam hall. But you must have this in the exam time synopsis, otherwise you will not be able to remember. Okay, now there is a big question, sir. Should I compile these acronyms separately, this fact separately, definition separately? No, that will not work. What will work? So that is a very disastrous approach if you try to, you know, have them separately, because then you will not be able to recall. You must have everything about one topic at single place, so that this chronology, this interlinking is happening in your mind also when you are revising. And in the exam hall, they ask anything about this topic and you are able to reproduce in the exam hall itself. Are you getting my friends? So don't try to compile facts at one place, data at one place, definition at one place. There will be, you know, complicating the preparation. All the hard work that you have done is undone. Are you getting? So you can do that in the second phase. Once you have completed this first phase, if you have still time, then you can do that. Don't try to compile, you know, from here and there. Don't do that. Okay. Now, so I have covered almost everything about the revision also. Now I want to tell you certain pitfalls or the red signals, which if you just keep in mind, and whenever you see your productivity is decreasing, you must be involving into any of these activities. So can you guess? Number one, wasting the time in estimating the cutoff. So not only those people who are appeared for the prelims 2020, but also those people who did not appear, they will also be guessing the cutoff. They will be useless discussion in the peer group, WhatsApp group, phone calls. Don't do that. In the moment you start calculating the cutoff, stop that. Rather go and enjoy Mirzapur 2 series, which is starting at the end of October. Okay, next is spending too much time on the current affair. That is also disastrous. Sir, I am reading 4 newspaper. I am devoting 6 hours, completely useless. There are a lot of people who came to me after the prelims examination and they say, sir, I did not cover my concept systematically. I ignored static portion. I just focus on the current affair compilation. That is useless. Okay, don't do that. Then daily answer writing without expert evaluation. You are writing answer, but you are saving the money. You are not getting the evaluation. Completely useless, right? Because unless you get the evaluation, you can't improve. If you just systematically write for 3 months, you can improve drastically if you have the very good evaluation and very good feedback. Okay, and try to be connected with your evaluator, with your mentor personally. Try to identify his mindset so that you can improve upon that. So one-to-one interaction is very, very important with your mentor. Waiting for the prelims result to start mains preparation. So there will be two categories of people. One is those people who will wait for the prelims and then start the mains preparation. And second is those people who will, you know, cover syllabus as if the examination is happening next week itself. So you have to have a very, you know, firefighting attitude. You can't wait for the prelims result to start your preparation. I already told you, you must complete 50% of your main syllabus by the time the result is declared. If you are able to complete, you are in the list. Otherwise, don't think that you have any chance of coming in the list. Then another is too much listening to the topper strategy. You are opening the YouTube and you are listening to 20 different topper. How is their answer writing strategy? What is their GS strategy? Completely useless. I am not saying don't follow this strategy, but wasting 2 hours and not learning anything, not implementing anything is useless. Ignoring revision tool. You are reading so much. You have compiled so many resources, so many current affair compilation, but did not do anything for the revision. Or you have just compiled the, you know, very cheap notes from many places, free notes from many places, but did not integrate them in a systematic manner, in the topic manner. That is also useless. And there is a tendency among the people that there is shortage of time, always thinking about there is very less time, very less time between the prelims and mains. My friend, this is for everyone, not only for you. So just focus on the current time. If you are writing the answer, write that carefully. Don't be so much anxious about your preparation. And then comparing with your peer. Sir, my friend's optional is very, very good. I am not that good, not good at that. Just learn from him, na. Just prepare your optional. Why are you wasting and comparing your time? Then ignoring the basics of self-discipline. That is also very dangerous. Because you are doing the IAS preparation, you don't have the luxury to ignore the self-discipline. Okay, these are some of the very basic tools. Now, whatever discussion I have done about the 360 degree approach to prepare the topic. So we have 900 plus GS mains topic, which includes GS1, GS2, GS3. And in this course, we are providing everything. This is mains booster course. And there are very happy students from this course, which are currently part of this batch. And we are providing everything in a systematic manner. Exam time synopsis, short revision clips. You know, we are also discussing the answers before the class. PPT based, mind map based, and exam oriented. This is completely exam oriented, where I have whatever example I have given to you, whatever screenshot I have shown you, those are from my own sessions, those are from my own research. Okay, then second initiative we have for the mains 2020-2021 people. So both of these initiatives are completely relevant for 2020 as well as 2021, because I already told you that you must prepare for the mains during next 3 to 4 months. Whether you are appearing for 2020 or 2021, it does not matter. So this is our second program, the GS Answer program. In this, we are also having one component, evaluation within 12 hours for very limited student. We will be taking just 20 students in this batch, where we can give the evaluation in 12 hours. And here we are asking you to have approach where you will be writing 2 questions daily plus the 10 questions on every Saturday. And in this manner, you will be enjoying the daily answer writing plus the complete test environment on the weekend also. And then we will be having the one-to-one interaction. We will be focusing on the most probable topic, the interlinking between the topic. We will be picking up the language of the UPSC paper and giving that. And then we will be providing the value addition tools also here, right? Good conclusion, introduction, how to make the mind map and all that, right? And this is another program which will be taken by another faculty. He is a very, you know, he's a civil servant plus the IITN. And this will be the essay program where we'll be focusing on how to increase the marks from average marks to the high marks, right? And this is completely relevant for those people who are struggling to increase the marks plus those people who are the beginners also, right? This is just 20 hours module where thematic preparation will be done. We will, the faculty will be picking 20 different themes and giving you the analysis of each of them, the focus on the structure making as well as the content, previous year questions analysis, essay writing challenge with the evaluation, and personalized feedback on the paper. So this is also also another course for the essay paper. And we are also coming up with the ethics module, which will be like kind of marks maximizer, right? So the purpose will be just to give you the value addition tool so that you can increase your marks. These are the free resources available on the website. If you are a fresher beginner, you can utilize them. NCERT short notes, daily current MCQs, crux, news prescription, optional strategy, then guidance webinar, which we are having right now also, free revision clips and compilations, the current affair and the UPSC previous year questions and their analysis. Okay, so let me now take you through, so just give me 3 minutes, 2-3 minutes, and now let me take you to our website and I can tell you how you can utilize various resources from the website. Okay, so you are here in the website. This is didaway.com. You just go to the courses and click here on the GS mains booster. So if you click here, you will be having the sample PDFs, etc., the list of 900 topic. So this research is based upon the methodology which I told you, based upon the previous year analysis, the current affairs, the syllabus, and based upon that we have compiled this list of GS3, GS2, GS1, and you can find here, right? And you can see like this list is covering very detailed topic list, and this is completely based upon the methodology which I told you, right? Similarly, on this page only you can see how to make the exam time synopsis. So the examples which I have given to you, we have given as samples here. So for example, you go to GS1, these are the exam time synopsis, religion and inhuman practices, one page like that. Other pages are also there. So you can see, for example, this topic of challenges faced by working women. Okay. Then you can see this topic of secularism in India. Okay. Concept, principle, context, then India's past, difference between the, from the Western secularism and other things, threat to the secularism, Gandhiji and secularism and so on. Then coming back here only, sorry, I took one extra step. So coming back in the GS1 study material, you can find, for example, this communal violence. So through this, you can understand when I say 360 degree coverage, what it means. So including everything, the recent context of the communal violence started in New Delhi. Then introduction, the past historical dimension starting from the medieval India and then post-independence, then recent development, then reasons of communal violence, the impact of communal violence, what the government has done, the different initiatives, then what is the provision in the constitution, social media and communal violence, what can be done and the way forward. So this is how we have done, and then we have given the exam time synopsis of the same topic. So the point is, if we are reading from the same source again and again and revising the same source again and again through the mind map, through the exam time synopsis, through the notes, same thing again and again, right? Don't, if you are following static from one area, current from another area in another institute, answer writing from third institute, compilation from fourth institute, which I told you many people are doing, so that will end up you nowhere, that will land you nowhere. At the end of the day, you have to prepare your systematic notes. So this effort is basically in that direction only. We have given this systematic course to cater to your needs, right? For GS3, GS2, GS1, and these are other features of this program. You are most welcome to join this. The seats are limited and open for a limited time, right? We have given everything about this course on this page, and the cost is very, very affordable for everyone. We try to reach out to the maximum people through this course so that the money do not become a barrier for you. Okay, now, so is everything clear to everyone? How is the session?